During the month of October, we all had the opportunity to help Valley teachers fund projects for their classrooms through Chevron's Fuel Your School program. The company isn't expected to formally announce all of the projects funded until the end of November.
But in tonight's Education Matters, Juanita Stevenson tells us about one special school that has already learned it's a winner.
From the outside, it may appear to be just another alternative or continuation school, but the teachers here see it differently.
Kids are here because they've had a lapse in judgment or gotten in trouble, and this is a second chance for them.
Many of the students also come to realize that the community day school is not the place they thought it would be.
It wasn't as bad as I thought it was. You know, I really liked it. Like, right when I first got here, I already had a lot of love, you know, like people coming to me. Not judging me by, you know, like what my past did and stuff, you know, just, you know, they see what I am inside. And
the community day school in the Clovis Unified School District accepts students 4th through 12th grade from throughout Fresno County. The staff here at the high school helps students get back on track academically with a focus on changing their behavior.
We want them to respond positively in the classroom, end disruptions, and be happier while at school so that they're more successful in the classroom.
There are 49 kids attending the high school. Many are from foster homes, group homes. There are no booster clubs or parents groups helping out. So when teacher Katie Hammond heard about Chevron's Fuel Your School grant program, she was excited.
And I was very interested in it because it was going to give me access to some technology if they did indeed fund it to especially help my special ed population.
Three teachers submitted grant proposals through Donors Choose, an online nonprofit where teachers can go online to post classroom projects for funding. This year, Chevron had committed to funding up to $200,000 worth of projects in Fresno County.
Education is just of paramount importance to us, and so that's one of the reasons that we are bringing Fuel Your School to Fresno County for the first time this year.
Just a few days ago, Hammond found out that all three projects received funding from the grant program. She had requested two iPads to help her special ed students.
We're excited about the iPads. It makes them feel special. When they're going to get them and have them in their hands, they're going to feel like, wow, you know, I mean something.
Another teacher requested garden equipment for the garden her students will soon plant. And math teacher Chris G requested a grant to help buy treats for the students.
A lot of our kids are group home, foster kids. So even though, you know, they're taken care of, they get food, there's a lot of little things they don't get. So this is our way of saying, okay, behave here and we'll give you some of the things that you normally don't get in a regular setting.
Hammond says the teachers here are willing to go the extra mile for their students because they think they are special and deserve the best.
Having a student like Carlos, they make me want to come to work every day. They make me happy. I love my kids and I love teaching in Alton because we make a difference every single day in the lives of these kids.
That caring from the teachers and a company that takes interest in young people isn't lost on these students.
You know, made me feel special, like, you know, they're paying attention to see that we really need stuff like that, you know, people that actually want it, you know. It makes me want to keep doing what I'm doing, keep doing good, push me forward still, not fall back.
It will be a few weeks before the gifts awarded through the grant program are delivered here at the school. But if you ask the teachers here, they will tell you they've already received their reward. For Education Matters, I'm Juanita Stevenson, KC24, local news that matters.
Juanita, thanks. And you may have noticed the Band-Aid on Carlos's face. That's from actually having his tattoos removed.
He's hoping to get a job in the near future. We sure wish him the best.